I'm Phil, and this is the Layer by Layer Layer, where I'm diving headfirst into 3D printing, painting, and modeling. For this initial layer, I'm printing the things that every printer needs right out of the box. Tools and upgrades. Are these the first things you should print? Stick around to see which ones are worth the filament, and which ones belong down the poop chute. So the first item that I printed as an upgrade was this poop chute, and I have been spending days now scouring the internet for poop chutes.
Ew!
I have been looking for designs of poop chutes, and I found this one on MakerWorld. There'll be links in the description that I really like, and I like it for a few reasons. One, it doesn't use any magnets. It uses this to seat in with the printer itself. And two, it comes with, don't like that sound, removable tray, and it comes with different sizes. So the profile actually has different sizes that you can print. It works really well, and it prints relatively quickly. Another nice feature of this poop chute is if you, say, drop it while you're filming a video, and maybe, I don't know, just hypothetically, the support on the back breaks, this piece can just be printed separately without this piece at all. So you don't actually have to reprint the whole thing. It's just this piece here. So I guess I've got something to print in the future. I really like this. 5 stars. Would print again. Highly recommended. Link in the description. All right, so the second upgrade that I printed was risers and also door holders. It's my understanding that when you're printing PLA, you want to have the door open a little bit on the P1S and also have the glass open so that the interior chamber doesn't get too hot. It says that on the BambuLab wiki from what I've been able to see. But if I'm wrong, go ahead and let me know in the comments. As my channel description says, I don't really know what I'm doing. These are the two prints actually that I found that I wanted to give a try out to. I actually combined these onto a single build plate so they all printed together instead of separately. The first one was door holders. I really liked these actually a lot. They're simple, they work great, and they're idiot proof, which is great for me because you can see here it says glass and case. And the other one also says glass and case, and so you really can't get it wrong. I've been using the larger one as I printed the rest of these. You can see that it's kind of gotten a little bit of a bow to it, but it still works just fine. Printed really well. The next thing was the top glass riser, which is these four pieces here. Really great. I know there's other options out there that have like hexagonal supports all the way across. They've got storage. Those all looked really cool, but I wanted to start with something simple, so I went with these. These go right on the back with the rounded spot. They fit perfectly. And then these front two, they go in the front. Again, fit perfectly. And the glass just slides right in. So overall, really great. Both of these, 5 stars, and links are in the description. Next up is the PTFE tool. And it's not just for PTFE. So this is a PTFE removal tool, so is this. This is actually for the control cable. So this allows you to very easily remove the PTFE tube. This allows you to remove the control cable very easily. And then this is for the top end of the PTFE tube going into the printer. At least that's what I think. If I'm wrong, go ahead and let me know in the comments. This was a really nice print. Printed up very quickly, doesn't use too much filament, and it works really well. Links are in the description, like they are for all of the other things. Now, if my understanding is correct, now that I'm doing this on YouTube, this will fill itself up as long as I just throw the filament at it. So we're gonna give that a try. Guess we'll do this the old-fashioned way. Maybe it doesn't work because I'm a new YouTuber. Maybe I only have some powers? Looks like I only have maybe the beginner's package of YouTube superpowers. If you wanna help me gain some more powers, please give this video a like and subscribe. Now on to the review for this. I was really excited about this one. I think it's a really cool concept. I like the fact that it's not using any ball bearings. I didn't want to have to deal with any more balls. The downside is that the filament swatches themselves are not particularly uniform. And so you can see here, they're getting kind of stuck up. And when they get stuck, they cause it to bind and sometimes jump out even of the filament holder. So it seems like this just needs to be widened up a little bit. Other than that, it's great though. So I would say 4 stars. Real quick, Phil from editing here. Not sure what I was thinking with a 4-star rating. I think I really just wanted it to work, and it is so, so close. It does seem to be mainly caused by the swatches not being standard, but I would want the design to account for it. So for now, dropping this down to 2 stars, but literally a few millimeters away from 5 stars. Okay, on to the next upgrade.
So next we're talking about a build plate holder, and this is one of the models that I found on MakerWorld. Again, like with all of them, links in the description. This one is functional, it works. It's not great. The print profile ended up printing with brims, which I don't think was needed. And one of the issues that I've definitely run into is that it's just so lightweight. I probably need to put some rubber feet or something onto the bottom because there's nothing that holds it to the printer itself. So it's supposed to go like right up against the printer, and then you can have your build plate and, you know, theoretically you slide it right in. Oh, wow. Hey, that worked. You slide it right in. If you get it right, it slides right in, but as you can see, it's a little bit tough to get it right the first time. I actually think that I'll probably end up just sort of slotting it in this way. So yeah, it really moves around quite a bit. And so not the best. I'd say 3 stars. I might go look for something else, but for now it's perfectly functional. These are the last 2 upgrades here, the most obvious one being this hexagonal spool. It's a reusable spool for the BambuLab filament, and it's pretty nice. It's got a little locking piece in here, so you clip it together and you lock it in. It printed out well, doesn't use too much filament. I did print it out of PLA, so you shouldn't use this in a filament dryer. Because you'll just end up with a broken spool. But I didn't have any other materials on hand to print it, and I needed an extra spool, so this is where we're at. The other thing is this filament clip, which I really like the concept of, but I'm so bad at using it, I haven't been able to both successfully film and use it in a way that wouldn't be tedious and torturous to an audience, because I'm pretty bad at it. So essentially, the concept is that you have one long bit of filament here that's on the spool, and then the actual loose end, and you just stick the loose end through this hole, and then you put this into here, and you basically just tighten it down, and it works really well. It's not the easiest thing in the world to use. A filament clip on the other side's probably easier, but these are the ones that I printed for now. I actually really like them. I'd probably give them like a 4 stars, maybe 5 to be honest, because I think most of the issue is me. As for the hexagonal spool, I'd give this maybe 4.5, 4 stars, maybe even 5. Again, it might just be that I'm not as good at putting it together. The clip on the inside, the locking clip right here, is a little bit difficult to get to and install. So not the easiest to use, but nice to in a pinch. It does take a while to print, but it doesn't use very much material, and it does have a nice spot for the label like the regular BambuLab spools. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. A reminder that all the things that I printed are linked down in the description, so you can go ahead and print them for yourselves. But did I miss anything? Are there any must-have upgrades that I just don't have a solution to yet? Let me know in the comments. And if you like the video, be sure to give it a like. And if you want to join me on this journey of learning about 3D printing, sculpting, while I try to make cool, nerdy sculptures in the future, be sure to subscribe. Have a nice day and happy printing.